everyone, so today I'm going to be doing a video which is newer to my channel. It is called Makeup of the Week, and you guys probably know about Outfits of the Week, but I wanted to kind of try something different and new, so I decided I would show you guys my makeup every day of the week. So I hope you guys really enjoy this video because I worked super hard on it, and if you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And hopefully I can do another one very soon because I had a lot of fun filming it and putting it together for you guys. All of the products that I used will be listed down below for the days that I did use them. So that is basically it. I just hope you guys enjoy it, and I'll see you in a minute. So for Monday's look, I wanted to start it with priming around my nose area with a pore minimizing primer by Benefit. Then for the skin, I wanted to go super lightweight but to also have a little bit of coverage to reduce some of the redness, so I chose a very lightweight foundation by Neutrogena. Now I'm applying a super brightening concealer, which is a must for me in those mornings when my dark under eye circles are super dull and just need some brightening in them. Now I am setting it with my NYX HD Powder. Swing my heart across the line, in my face is flashing signs. Seek it out and ye shall find. Old, but I'm not that old. Young, but I'm not that bold. And I don't think the world is sold. I'm just doing what we're told. So for this look, I did want to fill in my brows a little bit, so I'm doing that with my Milani Brow Fix Kit, and then I am setting them with my clear brow gel. So I'm adding some warmth into my face with a little bit of my Too Faced Milk Chocolate Soleil Bronzer. Then for the cheeks, I'm just sweeping a very light natural color by Benefit all over. Starting off with the eyes, I wanted to prime them using a MAC Paint Pot in Soft Ochre. Then I'm going to take my Naked 2 palette and I'm going to take the color Suspect and just add this all over the lid. It's a nice, warm, shimmery color. Then taking the color YDK, I'm going to blend this into my crease just to add a little bit more dramaticness into the eye look. Down this river every turn, hope is our four-letter word, make that money, watch it burn. Now taking my MAC 217 brush, I'm going to take a little bit of Busted and add this to the outer corner, slightly bringing it through the crease. Since I am using a lot of shimmery colors, I just wanted to pick up a light beige color called Foxy and just blend this over the darker shimmery colors to just tone it down a little. Then I added a little bit of a cool liner to my upper lash line and also tight line, which I didn't really get a good video of because it's really hard. And then I am curling my lashes and I'm going to prime my eyelashes first with my Maybelline eyelash primer. After I prime my eyelashes, I'm going to apply the Covergirl Flamed Out Mascara. For the lips, I'm starting off with super moisturized lips, and then I'm going to take one of my MAC lipsticks. This is called Creme Cup, and I'm going to just apply this all over to my lips and top it off with a NYX Butter Gloss and Creme Brûlée. That kills me, makes me feel alive. Starting with Tuesday, I'm going to first apply a mattifying face primer by Lorac just to keep my face matte throughout the day because I am going to be using a BB cream. This is the Maybelline Dream Fresh BB cream, and I'm going to rub this in with my fingers and then go in with my Real Techniques buffing brush and just blend everything out and make sure it's nice and blended. And then I'm just going to add some concealer underneath my eyes. And then I'm going to take a powder foundation and just press that into my skin so that it does not move the BB cream and it just mattifies my whole face.
Now for the cheeks, I'm going to use one of my favorite blushes from Smashbox, which is just a nice peachy pink color, and apply that to my cheeks. Next, I just wanted to add a little bit of a bronzy liquidy highlight just to the tops of my cheekbones. Katy Perry, Juicy J. For the eyebrows, I'm going to stick with the same clear brow gel that I always use every day just to keep my brows right in place. For the eyes, I just wanted to stick to some cream shadows, so I'm going to use two Maybelline color tattoos, the first in Barely Branded, and applying that one all over to my lids. And then I'm going to take the color Toughest Taupe, and I'm going to slightly blend this into the crease and outer corner, which is actually a really easy technique once you get used to it. Now I'm just going to line the upper lash line using my Makeup Forever eyeliner and smudge it out with my fingers. After I have curled my eyelashes, I'm going to apply a mascara to my top and bottom lashes. Now is when I add a felt tip liner and just add a slight wing to my eyeliner. And then I'm going to go to the lips and first line my lips using a Sephora lip liner. After that, I'm going to take my Marc Jacobs lipstick in the color Dizzy Spell and apply this to my lips and use a Revlon lip gloss over the top. And then I went back in and lined my waterline with a nude eyeliner. Moving on to Wednesday's makeup, I'm going to prime around my nose with a pore minimizing primer, and then I'm going to prime the rest of my face with a different mattifying gel primer. Now for foundation, I'm going to use the Covergirl 3-in-1 Stay Fabulous foundation and use my beauty blender to blend that out, and then I'm going to add the Maybelline Dream Lumi concealer underneath my eyes and also use the beauty blender to blend that out. She eats your heart out like Jeffrey Dahmer. Be careful, try not to lead her on. Shawty heart is on steroids cause her love. Once I'm finished with concealer and foundation, I'm going to set it with my NYX HD loose powder underneath my eyes and around my whole face. Then I am adding a nice rosy blush to my cheeks. So this day I did decide to fill in my eyebrows and I use the Milani Brow Fix Kit, and then I'm going to set them using my clear mascara. Now for the eyes, of course I'm going to start off by using an eyeshadow primer so that my shadows stay in place all day. Now I am applying the color Suspect from the Naked 2 palette all over my lid. Now I'm adding the color Chopper just to kind of the outer parts of my lid to give it that nice gradient effect. I've never seen a diamond. Now I am adding a nice coppery color to the crease. I cut my teeth on wedding rings. Then for the outer corner, I'm taking YDK and just blending that out with my MAC 217 brush to give it a more dramatic look. For highlights, I took a nice creamy matte white color and a peach color and put it in the inner corners and brow bone. So I just decided to curl my lashes and apply mascara off camera to save time, and then I applied my Revlon lip butter in Pink Lemonade. So Thursdays are our football games and I am a cheerleader, so I'm in my uniform, and I'm going to start by applying foundation and concealer all over to my face, and for this day I did not need to use a primer. You can call me Queen Bee, and baby I'll rule. Let me live that fantasy. A Of course, I am setting it with my NYX powder. We've cracked the code. We count our dollars on the train to the party. And everyone who knows us knows. So for the eyebrows, I'm going to use my clear mascara that I've been using all week. And then I'm going to take a NYX concealer and I'm going to outline my eyebrows and just kind of put it over some hairs that need to be plucked, and I need to get my eyebrows done. So this helps to hide it, also highlight it, and I used a Real Techniques brush for this, but then I used my finger afterwards and it worked a lot easier. And then I am just doing the same exact thing to my other eyebrows. I then applied a bright pink shimmery blush by e.l.f. to my cheeks. After priming my eyes, I'm just going to take a white shimmery color and apply this to the inner third of my lid. And then I'm going to blend a coppery warm eyeshadow color into the crease. For the outer corner, I use a shimmery dark chocolate brown color. So after we're finished with eyeshadow, I curled my lashes and applied the Covergirl Clump Crusher mascara. We crave a different kind of buzz. Let me be your ruler. Here I'm applying a NYX retractable white eyeliner to my waterline. And then I'm taking MAC lipstick in Creme Cup. So finally, we're moving on to Friday, and I'm going to, of course, use the same primer around my nose area to minimize the appearance of my pores. And then I just applied a foundation with a stippling brush, and then also added some concealer. So now I'm just setting it with my Rimmel Stay Matte Powder, and this is from the drugstore, and I think it's okay. I don't think it's super amazing because I did get kind of oily throughout the day, but I'm just going to apply that to my face, and then I'm going to create a contour with a contouring brush and then blend it out with a big little kabuki brush. So by now, I think you guys know the eyebrow routine, so I'll just let you guys watch. And then for the eyes, I'm just doing the same eye look I did yesterday, but I'm just using the Maybelline Color Tattoo in Barely Branded on the inner corner, just so that the shadow I'm putting on right now, which is the light shimmery color, can just stay on a little bit longer. And then I'm still blending that copper color into the crease and adding the dark chocolate brown into the outer corner. So after applying some mascara, I'm adding a little bit of the same MAC lipstick, and then this completes it for the whole makeup of the week. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys!